happening here at Calvary.
How many of you know that God's got something better in store for you? God has so, many great things
in store for you.
Can't you see?
Can't you see?
Many great,
things in store.
God has so,
many great things in store for you.
Can't you see?
Can't you see? Many great things in store.
God has so,
many great things in store for me.
Can't you see?
Can't you see?
Many great things. Great things. Come on, put your hands together like this.
Fret not thyself. Come on, somebody say, not this year. That's my subject. You already know that. Fret not thyself because of evildoers. Somebody say, not this year. Neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. Somebody say,
not this year.
For they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Somebody say,
this year.
Trust in the Lord and do good. So shall thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. The fourth verse is where I really have taken the crux of this message. It says, delight thyself. Delight thyself. Delight thyself. You do it. It's your decision. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thy heart. That's plenty to read for a message. You only need a couple of verses. I could go on down because verse 8 says, cease from anger and forsake wrath and fret not thyself in any wise to do evil. In other words, you have to make a decision not to do evil. I know you meant evil against me, but I don't have to repay you with evil. I'm going to give you back something you don't deserve.
Jesus.
Because when I give it back to you, everything I did to you has already been done. Verse 11, we can pick up, it says, but the meek shall inherit the earth until the light itself and the abundance. You can take your seats because I'm finished reading my text of scripture. We can get real caught up on that verse. We can get real excited about 13 because it says, the Lord shall laugh at him. Yes. Come on, look at my God. He's laughing at my enemies. The Lord shall laugh at him and the wicked, for he seeth the day. And his day is coming. Somebody ought to just underline in your Bible. His day is coming. You're talking about your enemies. You're talking about folk who have done things against you. You don't have to worry about it. Whoever they are. Oh my God. I've been tuned up and I feel them like I never felt them before. His day is coming. Then we can get excited about 14 because it says the wicked have drawn out the sword and have bent their bow to cast down the poor and the needy and to slay such as be of upright conversation. Verse 15 says, but their sword shall enter into their own hearts and the bow that they made to come against you is going to be broken. We can get excited because, I mean, all we have to do is skip down to verse 17. It says, for the arms of the wicked shall be broken. Everything they tried to do to you, God is breaking their arms. Oh, Jesus. We can get really excited at that, but one only has to skip down to verse 20. It says, but the wicked shall perish, and the enemies of the Lord shall be as the fat of the lambs, and they shall be consumed into the smoke, and they shall be smoked or consumed away. We can get excited there, but we have to skip down to verse 23 because it says, the steps of a good man or woman have been ordered by God. He knew what my enemy was going to do, but he also knew that it was going to set me up for what's getting ready to come into my life. They did it last year, but I'm getting ready to see the results of it this year. I need someone to say this year. We can get consumed in that, but verse 24 says, though he falls, it's talking about those who delight in the way of the Lord, though he falls, he shall not be utterly cast down. I fail, but I'm getting up. Yeah, folks have watched me and they have even plotted on whether or not I was going to survive when I'm in. They saw me down and some folks have even calculated that you'll never get up after this trial. But the righteous man falls, but he gets up. If you faint in the day of adversity, it just only means you got a little strength. But I need somebody to put your hands on your head. You may not understand it unless you understand the story of Samson and say, I feel my hair coming back. Yeah, you cut it. You thought you had me because you thought the power was in my hand. But the power is in my God. So we can get happy right there. But verse 25, we can get happy there. It says, I have been young. But now I'm older. Come on, someone say it's another year. Out of all the things I've seen the afflictions of God's people. I've seen frustration. I've seen bad economies. I've seen companies close down. I've seen folks go cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs and go crazy. I've seen folks turn into detriment. But there's one thing I ain't never seen. Come on, somebody just wave your hand and say, it's over my head. There's a word in my life. Last year I was in lack, but this year I ain't never seeing the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. I need you to slap somebody and tell him, not only am I his righteous, I'm his seed, and I ain't gonna beg this year, Lord Jesus. I don't have the right house. Tell somebody else, not only am I his seed, I ain't gonna beg this year. Come on, find one more person, tell them this is not my year to beg. Tell them everything that God has for me is coming into my hands. If I do what he says and comfort his promises, God's going to give it to me. Then we can get happy because verse 35 says, I've seen the wicked in great power and spreading himself like a green bay tree. Yet he passed away and lo was not. In other words, these enemies you have seen last year, you ain't going to see him no longer. God's about to allow them to pull a disappearing act. Don't you have anything to do with it? You don't know how they got away. You don't know when they left. You don't know when they disappeared. But every enemy, somebody in this house feels like your enemies have gotten away. They did the dirt. They did what they tried to do to you. And it looks like they are in peace. It looks like your enemy are prospering. But I come to tell you, the wicked only prosper for a moment. But those that have the favor of God on their life prosper forever. Come on, slap somebody real quick and tell them, I may be down right now, but honey, this is not my last state. This is only my present state. I'm down right now, but I got a day set. God's getting away. Oh, God, to turn this year, I'm trying to be calm. He's got a year set. This is my year that God's going to cause. And some of you have seen even the produce from things that your enemies have done to you. You've seen frustrating times, which it seems so perplexing, because sometimes David has to address the very thing that he sees. Particular psalm, we must understand that David has seen something happening around him. He has gotten so consumed with the fact that it looks like that while he is somehow not progressing, that his enemies are progressing. It looks like the folks that hate you, the folks that did you in, the folks that don't like you have it going on. But I've come to tell every saint of God, you can't judge things by how they look. It looks like your enemies have gotten away, but God is saying to the church of God that as we transition into this new year of prosperity, we got to understand that the prosperity of our enemies is not set in place for us to have our heads hung down. We must understand as children of God that God somehow always causes the things that happen around us to work in our favor. I need somebody in this place, because I feel the Spirit of God, just to touch a neighbor and say, neighbor, I know in last year, things got a little rough for you. I know. Lord, have mercy. I'm trying to go there that quick, Brother Anthony. But I know sometimes you've seen the progression of those who somehow have caused you depression. But I've come to speak to every enemy in your life, because this is the season the saints of God are getting ready to move to a new place in God. This is the hour now where the folks who have suffered in that last stage are getting ready to move to a new place in God. I need you just to lay your hands on somebody's shoulder and say, neighbor. God, I feel a preacher. Don't you say that. I'm going to say that. Say, neighbor. Neighbor. Oh, neighbor. God told me to tell you that it's time for you now to change your address. Lord, I ain't get nobody that's going to help me. Slap about three folks and tell them, I'm changing my address. Don't look for me where you saw me last year. Because last year, I got to be honest, I made some mistakes. And I did some things that God told me not to do, while I'm still living under the assets of decisions that I made that were not godly decisions. Slap somebody real quick and say, neighbor, God, God's getting ready to let me turn some things around. I need about 17 folks to do what she just did. You need to jump up and say, it's turning in my favor. Shut up. God told me to tell about 13 of y'all in this house, I'm getting ready to let it work in your favor. I know you're just like Joseph, and you got some brothers that hate what's getting ready to come. But I need you just to slap three folks and tell them they can't stop this. What you meant for evil, God's getting ready to make it work for my good. You thought
thought you were killing me, but you were setting me up. Because every setback for a saint of God is really a setup. I need about 12 folks to holler, I'm going high than I've ever gone before. I'm going to do more than I ever thought I was able to do. I need about 36 folks to jump up. This ain't hype, it's really the spirit. And say, I'm excited about what's coming this year. Because you must understand now that as David sits here on the precipice of watching the new year come in, he's now watching the fact that it looks like the enemy has gotten the advantage of him. It looks like the enemy now has the advantage. But I came to tell somebody in this place that as you're making changes and making New Year's resolutions and making New Year promises, there's one thing you cannot forget. Don't forget that while you're planning, to make sure you're playing. Because if you don't plan, you might as well plan to fail. If you don't take the time to set things out and map things in course, you're gonna find yourself at the same place you are this year. But since God has a word hanging over your life, I need about 30 folks to do that. I got a word that's hanging over my life. I'm gonna forget the hell of last year. I'm gonna forget the frustration of last year. I ain't gonna testify no more about what I went through last year. Because God has given me a new turn. Is there anybody here that thanks God for a new position in God? Slap about 3 folks and say, neighbor, every new year brings a new position. I failed him so many times before, but when I take the new year and I take a new day, I understand every day brand new mercies come into my life. Slap a neighbor and say, neighbor, and since I got new mercies and a new year, I'm getting ready to do a new thing. Slap somebody and say, neighbor, God's getting ready to let you do what you have not done before. Tell that neighbor, say, neighbor, go back, try it again. Just because you failed last year doesn't mean you don't have the oil. Just because you failed last year doesn't mean you can't get back up here. Just because they lied on you last year, it doesn't mean this is not your year. I need somebody lay a hand on a neighbor and say, neighbor, God told me to tell you he has anointed you for your double. Tell that neighbor, say, neighbor, did you hear what I say? Cause this is not 2007, but it's 2014. Lay your hands on a neighbor and say, neighbor, you ain't just gonna finish. You gonna finish strong. Every plan, every business, every foundation, every ministry, every dream, every idea, God's getting ready to let you complete it. Shake hands with a neighbor. Say name, double the anointing, double the income, double the victory, double the power, double strength, double victory. This year, God's getting ready to bless your socks up. You ain't seen nothing yet. Goodbye to the depression you sent in my life. I refuse to fret another day about the workers of iniquity. Last time, shake a neighbor by the hand. Shake that hand like you don't shake it off. Tell they meant it for evil. But it's working in my favor. It's working in my hands. Go ahead. I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready.
Jesus. Lord.
Yes, Lord.
The scripture says, don't spend another day. Somebody said, not this year. Giving the enemy any pleasure. The scripture said, don't spend another hour talking about what they did. You sowed in tears,
oh, yes, yes.
But you get ready to reap in joy. They made you cry, but now you get ready to dance. They tried to destroy you, but somebody said, I was still here. One thing you need to think, I'm closing. Father, we're going to get out kind of early. That's good for the dance. You need to celebrate the fact that he did not turn you over to the will of your enemies. Because your enemies didn't want to see you blessed. But somebody ran back and hollered, it's too late. I'm blessed now. You should have killed me. Is behind us. Now, I don't mean to stir up nothing. Some of y'all, the enemy wants you to be victim of your past. But your past is behind you. It did not disqualify you from your present or your future. It was really a setup. Because the enemy knew what he was doing. He would have never messed with you. But lean on a name and say, neighbor, I got more courage to keep on running. I believe I run on to see what the end's gonna be. Because the ending of a thing is better than the beginning. Every time I say better, I just have the Lord say, somebody high five, tell 10 times what they expected. They expected you to have nothing. They said 10 times better. Yes.
Let's make sure. Yeah, sit. Simply, simply. Yeah. Look at somebody turn this over. Deliver last year. It's a new year. Lord, y'all been talking. Y'all be back. Wait on somebody, turn this over. That was last year. Not this year. I refuse to be broke. That was last year. But this year, I shall have plenty. My God shall supply all of my needs. That was last year. I was sick, but not this year. He was wounded for my transgressions. Bruised. The chastisement of my peace was upon him.
Well, make sure you get the message.
So what you gonna do when last year enemies show up this year? Father, I'm not gonna fret myself because of evil doers. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord is gonna lift up a standard. So let the enemy come in. But when the enemy comes in, God's gonna send a flood to wash them away. And when the flood comes, it not only washes the enemy away, but wave your hands over a neighbor's head and say, God's getting rid of the residue of your enemies. You don't think better. You don't act better. You don't look better.
You ever been at work?
Or on the bus stop? Or at the gas station? Or at the restaurant? When folks don't understand you, you can't always do this. Because the waitress will call 911. They'll arrange for you to have a new wardrobe. They get you a nice white coat. Kind of ties in the back. But God says your response to your enemy has to be different this year. Look at somebody. I promise this is the last time I'll have you look at your name. I hope, I pray. Say name.
Name.
Sometimes you can't let the enemy know what's really going on. Tell whatever you do. Don't let them see you sweat. So this is what you do. Come at like you're messing with. Because sometimes you can't give him a full praise, but he understands the language of praise. So sometimes you're going to have to, hey! Because this year, things are going to be different. I ain't got no help up in here. Your boss man may not be here. Your frustration may not be in front of you. But can we just speak it in the atmosphere? Say, this year, things are going to be different. Lord have mercy. Some of y'all budgets weren't met last year, but I come to tell you, this year, things are going to be different. Some of y'all children act like ain't had this child. But I come to tell you, this year, things are going to be different. Some of y'all cars was acting up. But tell your car, this year, things are going to be different. Some of y'all have problems with your bills. You better make up in your mind. This year, things are gonna be different. Some of y'all need to go on a diet. You tried it last year. You failed somewhere about February. But you can go ahead and declare, this year, things are gonna be different. Some of y'all joined the gym last year. $7, $10 a month. You still